Good morning, students. Welcome to our biology class. Today we are going to learn chapter 14, transportation in plants and circulation in animals. What is transport? Transport means to carry things from one place to another. Have you ever wondered how the water and minerals move from the soil to the plant? And how the prepared food by the leaf is translocated to various parts of the plant? In this chapter, we are going to learn this. Means of transport in plants. The transport of materials in and out of the cells is carried out by different methods. Number one, diffusion, active transport, osmosis, plasmolysis, and imbibition. The transport of materials in and out of the cells is carried out by diffusion, active transport, osmosis, plasmolysis, and imbibition. We are going to learn one by one. Diffusion, the movement of molecules in liquid or solids from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration without utilization of energy is called diffusion. What is diffusion? The movement of molecules in a liquid or solids from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration without utilization of energy is called diffusion. Energy is not needed for this diffusion. So, this is a passive process. Look at this picture. Here, the movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. Example for this is, a drop of food coloring diffuses throughout the water. Next, active transport. Active transport. Here, the movement of molecules from lower concentration to higher concentration. Here, the movement of molecules from lower concentration to higher concentration, just opposite to diffusion. The active transport utilizes energy to pump molecules against a concentration gradient. Active transport utilizes energy. Active transport is carried out by membrane and proteins. This active transport is carried out by membrane and proteins. Proteins use energy to carry substances across the cell membrane. Hence, they are referred as pumps. Active transport. Here, the movement of molecules from lower concentration to higher concentration and it utilizes energy. Look at the picture. Here you can see the movement of molecules from lower concentration to higher concentration using the energy. Next, osmosis. Osmosis is the movement of solvent or water molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. Here, osmosis is movement of solvent or water molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. This process is carried out till an equilibrium is reached. So, it is a passive movement. Osmosis takes place in liquid medium only, but diffusion takes place in any medium like solid, gas, and liquid. Plasmolysis. When water molecules moves out of the cell, and resulting in the shrinkage of cell membrane away from the cell wall. See this picture. Here, the contraction of protoplast of a plant cell as a result of loss of water from the cell.
as a result of loss of water from the cell, that is shrinkage of protoplasm. Next, imbibition. Imbibition, it is a type of diffusion which a solid absorbs water and gets swelled up. Imbibition is a type of diffusion when a solid absorbs water and gets swelled up. Example, absorption of water by seeds. Here you can see the imbibed seeds in the test tube. Now we have learned the different means of transport in plants. They are diffusion, active transport, osmosis, plasmolysis and imbibition. Root hair, structure of root hair. Root hairs are water absorbing unit. Root hairs are water absorbing unit. This is a structure of root hair. There are millions of root hairs on the tip of the roots. You can see there are millions of root hairs on the tip of the root. Root hairs absorb water and minerals by diffusion. What's the function of root hair? Root hairs absorb water and minerals by diffusion. Root hairs are thin-walled, slender, extension of epidermal cell that increase the surface area of absorption. Root hairs are thin-walled, you can see, thin-walled, slender, extension of epidermal cell that increase the surface area of absorption. Next, pathway of water absorbed by roots. You can see the pathway of water absorbed by roots. Once the water enters the root hairs, the concentration of water molecules in the root hair cells become more than that of cortex. These are cortical cells, that is cortex. Once the water enters the root hairs, the concentration of water molecules in the root hair cells become more than that of cortex. Thus, the water from the root hair moves to cortical cells due to osmosis. In osmosis, movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. We already learned, isn't it? So, the water from the root hair moves to the cortical cells by osmosis and then reaches the xylem. From the xylem, the water is transported to the stem and leaves for photosynthesis. Once the water enters the root hairs, the concentration of water molecules in the root hair cells become more than that of cortex. Thus, the water from the root hair cells move to the cortical cells by osmosis and then reaches the xylem. From the xylem, the water is transported to the stem and leaves for photosynthesis. This is the pathway of water. Here you can see the flow chart. Root hair cells absorb water. From that, the water is moved to the root cortex cells, then xylem vessels, then xylem and stem and leaves. Next, types of movement of water into the root cells. Once water is absorbed by the root hairs, it can move deeper into the root layers by two pathways. When water is absorbed by the root hairs, it can move deeper into the root layers by two pathways. They are apoplast pathway and symplast pathway. They are apoplast pathway and symplast pathway. Apoplast pathway. You can see the green color pathway. In the picture, you can see a green color pathway. This is apoplast pathway. The movement of this pathway occur through the intercellular spaces. The movement of this apoplast pathway occurs through the intercellular spaces. Intercellular, what is intercellular spaces? The space between the cells are called intercellular spaces. In apoplast pathway, movement of water occurs through intercellular spaces and cell wall. Intercellular spaces and cell wall. This apoplast pathway does not cross the cell membrane. Apoplast pathway does not cross the cell membrane. This movement is dependent on the gradient. this movement is dependent on the gradient. That is, gradient means incline. You can see the picture, that green color pathway, that is apoplast pathway. It moves through the intercellular spaces and cell wall.
Simplest pathway. In simplest pathway, the water travels through the cell, that is cytoplasm. The water travels through the cell, that is cytoplasm. Intercellular movement is through plasma desmata. Plasma desmata is a bridge or microscopic channel between the cells. In simplest pathway, water enters the cells through cell membrane, hence the movement is slower. Blue color shows the simplastic pathway. The water moves through the cell membrane, cytoplasm and plasma desmata.
Okay students, we have learned two types of pathways for the movement of water into the root cells. They are apoplast and simplest. Hope you can understand these topics. Thank you students.